The ancient history that we learn in school is presented to us as the only scientific version of our ancient history. And still, many people nowadays doubt its validity and its consistency for the simple reason that the megalithic structures that the ancients have left for us are so huge and so sophisticated that even we, the so-called advanced tip of the civilization now, cannot build with our so-called modern technology. Very few people, however, doubt the validity of the recent history. It seems almost impossible to make all nations on this earth to forget their recent events, their recent history, and start believing in something that did not happen in reality. Strong evidence is emerging, however, that even our very recent history has been falsified and has been altered beyond recognition. In this video, I will present evidence that indeed our history has been stolen away from us and continues being reshaped in a fraudulent way even nowadays. And also, I will make an attempt to reconstruct our real history, and that will be an amazing saga of the survivors of the older advanced civilization that many call Atlantis. The culture, the full culture, civilization, the cities and everything belonging to the Atlanteans was blown up. It was destroyed from inside by parasitic malicious entities. But many of the people actually survived and scattered all over the globe and started educating the primitive humans that were residing on the rest of the planet, and bringing them to higher standards of life, and most importantly, awareness of the amazing spiritual and magical capabilities of the human race. However, the malicious parasites that destroyed Atlantis did not just fly away and live forever. They continued chasing and hunting down the survivors and all traces of the spiritual Atlantean culture. This video will be about the ruthless wars against the survivors in the last 1,000 years of our history. It will become clear that many of the so-called mysteries of ancient, very ancient and very old advanced civilizations are not at all ancient, and in reality have happened in the very recent past, but have been artificially sent to the very far away distant past by so-called historians to make them look unimportant. By distorting the history of the survivors beyond recognition and by sending it to the far, far away past, the parasitic forces in the society are continuously trying to make the human race forget its rightful claim to a glorious heritage of majestic, magical, spiritual beings that are well aware of their place in the vast universe, which is a complex ecosystem of beings, many of whom are far, far superior than us. A lot of the information in this video will be absolutely new and absolutely unique, even for those who have been researching ancient mysteries for a long time, because it is published in English for the first time. Let's start with a small quiz. Guess which city is this? I will give you plenty of clues. This is a resident of this city, and I will show you even more photos of the same location. The answer of the quiz is Tokyo, and European-style buildings you saw were supposedly built in neoclassical architectural style, according to the official history. However, that is quite hard to imagine in reality, because in that time period, Japan was a very traditional country, practically closed to the rest of the world. The possibility of these buildings being built later on, after Japan opens itself for the rest of the world, is also extremely unlikely. This will be reviewed in detail later on in the video. Guess to which ruler do these helmets belong? Well, these are the helmets of the Russian emperors, the Christian rulers of Russia. The explanation of the official history is that the kings were, of course, Christian, and they were wearing these flowery elements without understanding their meaning at all, just like that, for decoration. They are assuring us that at that time the Christians and Ottomans were bitterly fighting each other, yet the very king would wear inscriptions from the Quran on his own forehead. Not only that, but the Arabic inscriptions are found on most pieces of weaponry as well, including most of the swords and everything else. And at the same time, their enemy, the supposedly enemy, the Ottomans, who are nowadays portrayed to us as some sort of fanatic Muslims, are portrayed as Christians. Some of the rulers of the Ottoman Empire, not all, are portrayed by the contemporary historians of that time as Christians. And even most of the government body, most of the government officials of this particular Christian ruler were Christians as well. Let's try to understand why the archaeological artifacts show a reality that is so far away from the history that we are used to. What we call history now was fabricated very recently, just a couple of hundred years ago, by a very small group of medieval scholars, the core of whom were Joseph Scaliger and Dionysius Pitavius. They had to manufacture this version of history to justify the actions of the rebel, the insurgent kings that took over the rulership of all countries in Europe at that time, and needed some sort of justification for their action and some sort of new history that will help them stay on the throne. To make it look real, of course, they needed some sort of confirmation, some sort of old information that would substantiate it. And that was very easy to get from the so-called ancient Greek and Roman sources. We are being assured that the ancient Greek and Roman books have survived till nowadays, and there are plenty of them, and they are a valuable source for our most ancient history. However, a small detail that is usually forgotten and is not mentioned when this version of history is discussed is the fact that all these so-called ancient books are not at all available in original. they are available only as copies. And amazingly enough, all of these copies were written by a very, very small groups of monks exactly at the time when the new Scaliger Petavius history was being fabricated, and it is not even alternative or questionable history. It is well known that when the monks were copying the old books, they were not making an exact copies, but they were also adjusting the content to the newly fabricated picture of history. And if you wonder what happened to the originals that the monks were using to make these copies, well, very conveniently, all of them, without exception, burned in some sort of accidental fire here and there. All the libraries, by chance, all the old libraries burned, and all the originals burned at that time. However, in the very same libraries, the fire was devouring selectively only the old books. The copies never burned in that fire. Well, they must have been fireproof. I don't see any other explanation. After the new history was fabricated, it was ready for implementation into the society to change the way people view their very existence, their very origin, and that was done with military power. It was not that people thought that this is their history. They were forced to accept it. Of course, many refused to accept it. And those who refused were given other choices. Other choices of how you want to meet your creator. Being burned or maybe in some other way. But before discussing in detail how our real history was substituted with semi-truthful historical fiction, let's first of all find out what was the real situation and for whom was it so uncomfortable that they had to undertake this enormous task of brainwashing a couple of generations to the extent that they really forget who they are, where did they come from, and who are their real forefathers.